The following segment is sponsored by Austin Radiological Association. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as we continue to focus on our health in the new year, it's important to be aware of the risk factors and symptoms of certain diseases. We've got Dr. Nguyen from the Austin Radiological Association to tell us about peripheral arterial disease, how to spot it, and, of course, how to treat it. Doctor, good morning.
Jordan, man of steel. Thank you for having me.
Did you hear that, man of steel, from
man
a doctor himself?
How
I got to shake your hand. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
All right, so let's talk about the disease first. Arterial peripheral disease. What is it?
So peripheral arterial disease, or PAD,
right.
A lot of people know about coronary disease.
Mm-hmm.
So I tell patients that PAD is basically coronary artery disease's brother, right? So plaque forms in the arteries that supply the legs, right, the tissues, and they form blockages. And those blockages diminish the amount of blood flow to the legs and to the tissue,
okay.
Which means there's less oxygen getting
okay.
down to the legs and the muscles. So patients develop symptoms with minor activities. They'll describe it as leg pain or cramping
mm-hmm.
that occurs. It'll occur with walking short distances. And as that that disease progresses, they'll develop that cramping with shorter and shorter distance of walking. The patients
uh-huh.
will eventually develop pain at rest, such as when they go to sleep at night, they got to lie flat
mm-hmm.
and blood flow doesn't travel their legs because they don't have the aid of gravity. Some patients may even develop minor wounds or wounds following minor injuries that won't heal. And some patients may have to progress to the point where sometimes you have to consider amputation.
Wow, really?
Yes.
So this would happen, I'm assuming, a little bit later in life,
right.
typically?
Right. So, yes, as you get older and you know, the risk factors that contribute to smoking, poorly controlled diabetes,
right.
age, as those progress, then these symptoms can progress further and further and get worse and worse.
Okay. We have a couple cases that Dr. wanted to show us this morning and kind of break down what's going on. So we've got a couple slides here. So what are we looking at?
So this is a fluoroscopy. This is a fancy, basically a fancy x-ray machine that is looking through the legs.
Okay.
And what we have is a patient who is, brought to us because of severe pain in his legs. He's had a history of severe coronary artery disease and severe peripheral arterial disease.
Okay.
Actually even had bypass in his heart.
Wow.
So what we're looking at on the far left, this first picture, is we have a catheter, a tube that's inserted at the very top of the leg. This is his thigh. This
okay.
is left thigh and leg. And we have a tube inserted at the top. And we're injecting some dye to look at those arteries. And the encircled in red is a huge blockage. That blood flow should be traveling all the way down the thigh.
You should be able to see it.
You should be able to see it traveling all the way down.
So then what are you doing here?
So what we've done is we've worked it from both directions. It's a very challenging, very hard plaque. And we've worked from backwards to go into that artery, going backwards to cross through that blockage
okay.
and get into the open portion.
So basically
right?
you're just trying to help open it up. And
we're
I know this is
going to
switch
exactly.
soon. So I want to real quick zoom on to the next example we have here. Is this a similar situation?
Similar situation. This patient actually was referred from the podiatry and wound care doctor because of a wound that just wouldn't heal.
Okay.
And we've targeted a vessel that is blocked right about here. There's no good blood flow down here. So what we've done, we've targeted the specific artery that supplies that wound
right.
to try to get blood flow and oxygen back so they would heal. And we've actually, in the second picture, crossed that blockage. And in this third picture, we're using a tiny little device. I described to patients like a little Dremel tool.
Okay.
A little sander. It's sanding
okay.
down that plaque, softening it up so that we can balloon that artery and restore flow. So now we got flow all the way back down, all the way back down that vessel here.
And then will it stay like this?
So the longevity depends on controlling those risk factors, I said,
right.
smoking, exercise. But that patient's wound healed in several weeks.
Gotcha. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Here's a quick look at some video of what it's like to, I'm assuming, put the catheter in.
Well, so here's, you know, in that last case, you know, I told you about that little Dremel-like tool,
right.
right? And so this is that little device, as you can see.
Oh, this is it.
That's
right there.
It right there. So this little device right here is a little tool with a little sander, and
okay.
basically we're sanding that plaque down,
huh.
making it softer so that when we balloon it, the vessel will respond to that ballooning and stay open.
Nice.
So that's what we're doing right now. We're sanding that down, and again, got a great result.
Is this something a patient would have to go under?
We do it under what's called conscious sedation. So it's
okay.
not general anesthesia. It's actually potentially an elective procedure that we carry out, you know. We can do it, you know, in an outpatient setting for patients.
Last question I have is when you go through this process,
mm-hmm.
the patient who was maybe bedridden or, was having difficulty walking because of that blockage, mm-hmm. are they immediately feeling difference in the way their legs feel?
They very much can. I mean, typically, if you're talking to a patient with rest pain, for
mm-hmm.
example, they're having pain just at rest. When you do that procedure within the next couple of days, they automatically feel much better because they're getting blood flow that wasn't present before.
It's amazing.
Back down there, for sure.
I can't imagine
yeah.
being the first doctor to come up with that idea, you know?
You know, it's been around for a while. the first interventional radiologist stented in 1964, Charles Dowder. So it's actually been around. It's evolved quite a bit since then. It's very much matured since then. So
Western medicine obviously helps so much. And you guys do so much at ARA.
We do.
For folks who maybe have more questions or want to chat with you guys directly, I'm assuming they can just reach out. You guys have many locations around Austin.
Yes, we have many locations around Austin. We have a website. They can always contact us. We'll be more than welcome to both screen them for PAD. You know, a lot of the screening tests, such as ultrasounds, used to look at those arteries. We do the screening, and we'll for sure work with them to treat them, work in conjunction with their primary care doc, other specialists, put them back on their feet.
Yep. Thank you.
For sure.
Dr. Nguyen, thank you so much.
Nice to talk to you. Thank you so much.
Nice little tutorial there for us. They know so much at ARA. We really appreciate it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, we're going to get